process capability must only be analyzed after the process is brought within statistical control. We talked about that in and used SPC or statistical process control and control charting to see whether or not a process is in control. Once that is done, then we can analyze or assess process capability. The natural variation of a process should be small enough to produce products that meet the standards required. So a process in statistical control does not necessarily meet the design specifications. Process capability is a measure of the relationship between the natural variation of the process and the design specifications. This view graph, This view graph shows us what we mean by that. So here we have a lower and upper spec limit, but we can see that in this part A, the process variation is well within the spec limits, and so this process is capable of meeting specifications. Whereas in this one, the process is not capable because there is a good portion of the process output that falls outside of the spec limits. So process capability ratio can be computed by subtracting upper and lower spec limits and dividing that difference by Six Sigma, where sigma is the standard deviation of the process, or it could be the sample standard deviation as an estimate of the standard deviation of the process. A capable process must have a capability ratio of at least one. And we must again realize that capability ratio does not look at how well the process is centered in the specification range. Often a target value of C sub P equal to 1.33 is used to allow for off-center processes, just because we don't necessarily know, may not know what the process center is like. So Six Sigma quality requires a capability ratio of 2, and we will see that in this next view graph. Or maybe not in this one. This is an example. A manufacturing process has a mean of 210 minutes. Process standard deviation sigma is 0.516 minutes. So, and design specification is 210 plus or minus 3 minutes. So computing C sub P, upper minus the lower spec limit would be 210 plus 3, that's 213, minus 210 minus 3 is 207, and then we divide that by 6 times 0.516. So in this case, we have a C sub P equal to 1.938, and the process is capable. One-sided process capability indexes should be computed, and that's what I call worst-case indexes. These must be computed, capability indexes must be computed, because they tell us about the center of the process. So we compute two indexes, a C sub PU and a C sub PL, or for lower and upper. So upper spec limit minus the center of the process divided by 3 sigma gives us the upper one-sided index. And instead of mu, we can use X bar if we are sampling, of course. And then C sub PL is computed for the lower half, or mu minus lower spec limit divided by 3 sigma. The minimum of those two is C sub PK. or capability index. Now, CISO-PK measures the difference between the desired versus the actual center of the process. It informs us about the center of the process relative to specification limits. A capable process must have a CPK of at least one. And in the next slide, we will see that a capable process is not necessarily in the center of the spec limits, but it falls within the spec limits at both extremes. So here we have a CPK that is negative in value. So if this is the lower spec limit, and if this is the upper spec limit, and if this is our process output, and the center of it falls outside of the spec limit, in this case upper spec limit, then we have a CPK that would be negative. Similarly, we could have the process, instead of it being on the right side, it may be behaving so that, over here. So the center of the process is outside of the lower spec limit. So in this case also we would have a CPK that is negative. CPK of zero means that this average or the center of our process, of the output of our process, falls on one of the spec limits, either lower or upper spec limits. A CPK between 0 and 1 means that the process center is within the spec limits. Here's the process center, and it's within the spec limits, but it's off center. It's not on the target. In fact, if this is the target for the spec limits or for the tolerance, and if we have 1, 2, 3, let's say this is the target right here. Then if the process center falls at this point or one-third of the way to the left of the target or one-third of the way to the right of the target, then that would mean that a CPK is equal to 0.67. And if it falls over here, if the process center falls over here, or two-thirds of the way to the left, then the CPK would be 0.33, and if it falls on the spec limit, then of course that would be zero, as in this case that was shown. Okay, and a CPK of 1 means that the average or the mean of the process falls exactly on the target, and that means that the entire variation within the process, or from the entire output, would fall within the spec limits. This is why a CPK of equal to 1 is generally not very trustworthy, and because the process center might shift, then a lot of the cases a CPK of 1.33 is recommended. So a CPK of that is greater than 1 means that the process is centered and the distribution is well within the target limits or within the tolerance limits. So the bigger the CPK is, then the smaller the variation or the standard deviation of our process would be. So the process would be much more peaked and would have a narrower base down here. A CPK of equal to 1 is generally referred to as the process behaving within or capable within 3 standard deviations. A CPK of 1.33 is known to be capable of within 4 sigma or 4 standard deviations. A CPK of 1.67 is known to be capable of 5 sigma, and a CPK of 2 is associated with 6 sigma or process capable within 6 sigma or 6 standard deviations. And by the way, just to go back here, if we have a CPK producing within 3 standard deviations, or CPK equal to, if you have a process producing within 3 sigma or CPK of equal to 1, that means fewer than 2,700 defects per million. And if, and if we have a CPK of 2.0, this one, then that means 3.4 defects, DPMOs, defects per million opportunities. So 3.4 defects in a million versus 2,700. That's the difference between a CPK of 1 and a CPK of 2.0. Okay, so to compute the CPK or probability index, capability index, a new cutting machine is under consideration. The process mean for it is 0.25 inches. The process standard deviation is 0.0005 inches. And we have upper and lower spec limits. So to compute the minimum of the two, the CPL would be the process mean, which is 250 minus the lower spec limit, which is 0.25 minus 0.249 divided by 3 times standard deviation, which is 0.0005. And then the CPU would be the upper spec limit, which is 0.251 minus 0.249, the process center or the target value or the oops, what have I done here? 0.251 minus 0.250. 0.250, which is the mean, divided by 3 times 0.0005. And the minimum of, in this case, both of these numbers happen to be 0.67. 0.67. And so the minimum of the two would be 0.67. And because CPK is less than 1, then we say that this machine is not capable of meeting our design specifications. A different way, so we've already talked about this, a different way of computing CPK, or the capability index, is to take the capability ratio, or C sub P, and multiply it by 1 minus a constant, where that constant is given with this formula, and K is a number between 0 and 1. So if generally, we can talk about how well-centered a process is if we look at the ratio of CPK over CP. If that ratio equals to 1, then process center falls on target. but 1 minus that ratio right there tells us the percentage by which the process is off target. So for example, if CPK over CP for a process happens to be 0.67, then that mean 1 minus that is 0.33, which means that the process is off target by 33%. It's off target by 33%. And where is it off target? Where is it off target? This doesn't look right. Let me redraw that. If this is the tolerance, and let's say our process is like this, for instance, or this is the target, and this is our process mean, then to know whether or not it's off target to the left or to the right, we can decide that by this rule. If compare the CPL and the CPU to the CP, to the capability ratio. If CPL is lower than CP, then the average or the center of the process is closer to the lower limit. But if CPU is lower than the CP, then the process mean is closer to the upper limit of the spec limit of the tolerance. Okay, so we've already talked. I don't know why I have this one here again. So here's reserve problem 8.7. It says the temperature in a computer lab at Coyote University is very important for proper functioning of the computer equipment. The data in the worksheet, and I have the data in a minute for you, shows the results of 30 samples of 5 each, taken at random at different times of the day over a 3-month time period. Calculate the process capability statistics for the temperature in the computer lab. The upper tolerance is 76 and the lower tolerance is 68. What recommendations would you make to management concerning the process based on these findings? So if the process, if the tolerance is between 68 and 76, then that means that the target for the target value in the tolerance should be 72, which is halfway between these two between our lower and upper spec limits. So with that let me go to the data for this problem, and here's the statement of the problem again, and let me increase the font a little bit, and here's our data, right? And so to do all of this calculation, your authors have a template, Excel template, that they have provided. So I'll go ahead and use that because it's a lot simpler, and all we want to do is just interpret the results. So here is the data. I'm going to copy it and bring it to the template, and oops. Okay, so here's our data, and you can see that our histogram is being formed, but only with one data value or one bar, because we haven't specified the number of classes. We do know that the nominal specification, or that target value within the tolerance range, is 72, and the lower upper spec limit is 76, and the lower spec limit is 68. This was given to us in the problem statement. With that, and given that we have the data in here, the template tells us that the minimum of the data and the maximum of the data are what values. Then it tells us enter the number of cells below. So we need to use up to 10, we can use up to 10 classes or up to 10 bars in our histogram. So I'll just do 8. And then the software tells us, or the Excel sheet tells us, enter the smallest and largest limits for the frequency distribution below. The lower limit should be slightly less than the data minimum. So here's the data minimum value right there, and slightly less than that, I'll go ahead and use 69. And then it says the upper limit should be slightly larger than the data maximum. So 74.8, I'm just going to use 75. And when I enter, you can see that that the histogram will be formed. And this looks fairly centered. Looking at the results, the average for the process is 72.07. Standard deviation is 1.268. These are numbers that we can use in our equations that I showed you before to compute these capability information. So C sub P, which is the capability ratio, C sub PL and PU, which are the one-sided indexes, and then C sub PK, which is the capability index. So we can see that C sub P is 1.05. So it's almost close to 1, but it's not much higher than 1. So the process is capable within 3 sigma, or within 3 standard deviations, but it is recommended for variation or variability within the process to be lowered or brought to be reduced, so that we can have a more capable process, and we can have more faith, in fact, in terms of the production of it. C sub PL and C sub PU are given to us here. C sub PL and C sub PU are given to us here. And notice that C sub PU is lower than C sub P. It's 1.03. And because that's the case, then we can assume that the process center is a little bit more skewed, or on the side of the upper end of the spec limit. So